Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. To understand the concept very clearly, please watch the video till the end. Once you are done with watching the video, do not forget to like, comment, subscribe and hit the bell icon. Today we are going to learn about exporting the data from SAS to different files like Excel, text and something else. So to export the data, it is important that you should have one source and one destination. For source, it is quite obvious that it's going to be SAS. And for destination, in the scope of this video is Excel, all the three formats like XLSX, XLS and CSV. Before we proceed further, I would just like you to take a note that we have already made a video on how to import the Excel file in SAS. If you have not seen that yet, go to our channel and watch this video, or you can directly click the link of this video showing just right here. Now let's go to the SAS. While you might have remembered, while we were doing the SAS University download and setup in Windows environment, we did created these folders. If you have not seen that video yet, please click the link right here and watch the video. So we created the folder My Folders, and inside that SAS automatically created this folder, and inside this folder we created another folder which is called Excel Files. That was just for our convenience. Okay, let me just show you that once. Okay, here is that. So this one was the folder which we created. Now whatever we export, whatever we going to export, that will come over here. Let's go and try that. So here in the library mylib we have all of these tables. Now we would try to export all of these three tables one by one. So first let's take an example about customer details. How we can start it? First you need to type proc export, then provide the data which is residing in mylib library, and the table name is customer details. Then you need to provide the location. How will you get the location? So that location you cannot take it from here. That will not be acceptable by SAS. So for that you need to just come over here and go to the server files and folders, and the Excel file folder which we created, I just explained to you, right click that and go to properties. From here you can copy the location, put this location in the quotations, and now you need to provide the file name which I am going to say customers, and then you need to provide file format in what format you want to export the data. So for now I am going to take for example XLSX, and then you need to type DBMS, and you need to say SAS checkout. If XLSX file with this name exists, just replace that and create the new one. You can also provide the sheet name. That's the optional argument. If you don't want, you can just run without providing the sheet name. But for now, I'm just going to show you the example. So I'll put the sheet name. Let me just copy this once again and put it over here. End with a semicolon. Sorry. And then type run, hit the run button. Let's go to this folder and see. So here we have the file created customers. We can see. So here the customers have been created. Okay. So this is how you can export the data from SAS to Excel. Now it was exported to XLSX. Let's try to export it to XLS. So you don't have to do anything much. Just put the format, and while providing the DBMS detail, you just need to put the same format with replace. Let's go back to here, and you can see here the XLS file has been created. Let's try to export it in CSV. CSV, and put CSV over here as well. While you are exporting in CSV, you just don't need to provide the sheet argument. Just come over here and you can see the CSV format is also comma separated value has also been created. All right. Now, another example we're going to see, I will just undo this all and make it XLSX. Now we would learn how to export multiple tables in one Excel file. This is how you can create as many Excel files as you want. But what if you want to put all these tables here, all these customer tables in the same Excel file, but on different sheet? Let's look at that. So just copy this and change the table name which you want to export. This time I want to export customers, this one, and file name is going to be same, and this I'm going to change customers. Or maybe I can do one thing here. I will put customer details. I'll change the sheet name. And here I'll just put customers. Okay. Just run this. Let's go to this and open the XLSX file. Which one is the XLSX file? This one. Is that one? No. What was the Excel file name? Customers only. So where is the customers? This one, this one, and this one. Where is the customer? This one is 9070 customer. Why is it showing customer details? Well, I am exporting it customers sheet name, it's showing. Let me just run this. Okay, let's just remove all these Excel files first. Okay. Now, let's run this once again. Come over here. Sorry. Here the customer table is created. Customer details both are created. Okay. Let me just remove this. I just want to export only one table, which is this. So by looking at, though we are facing some kind of issue, but this also helps you understand how to fix some problems which comes through. Okay, so let's look at this. This time it is created as customer details. Now let's go and run the second proc export statement. Let's go back to here, do a refresh and try to open this. Now you can see customers data is also exported. Now let's try to export the third table. Okay, the third table name is customers 2, and the same sheet name I'm going to put customers 2. Export this, go back to folder, just do a refresh, file is created, and here you can see customers 2. So this is how you can export as many files as you want. You can create separate files, you can create one file with multiple sheets. Thank you very much for watching the video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and put your problems in comment section. Thank you very much once again. Wish you very good luck.